Greetings. Here, what is I power I? Imaginary number raised to the power of imaginary number equal to what? Any guesses? You see, I power 0 is equal to 1, and I power 1 is of course I, and I square is negative 1. This is remarkable. I square is negative 1, and I cube is negative I. Yeah, I square into I, that is minus 1 into I is negative I. And I power 4, we can go like this. I power 4 is positive 1, and I power 5 is positive I. Yeah, so on, we can keep on go like this. But what is I power I? Yeah, thinking, right? So now Euler says that, hey, you don't worry, I'm here to help you. So Euler's formula, if I use Euler's formula, then it is like this. Say for example, e to the power of I theta is cosine theta plus I sine theta. All right. Now slowly you plug in theta is equal to pi by 2. So if I plug in theta equal to pi by 2, so we get now e power I pi by 2 is cosine pi by 2 plus I sine pi by 2. Now what is cos pi by 2? So cos pi by 2 is 0 and sine pi by 2 is 1. So therefore e power I pi by 2 is this positive I. So e power I pi by 2 is this positive I. That means you come here and this I, in this I you plug in this. Okay, so you plug in e power I pi by 2 in this I. So now we can construct something like this. So therefore e power I pi by 2 whole power again I. Okay, this is what now? So this is e power I multiplied by I pi by 2, and this stuff is what here now, e to the power of minus pi by 2. Okay, now you can plug in this pi as 3.1415, so on, or e power minus pi by 2, you can do this. Now you would get approximately like this. So you would get approximately 0.207879, so on. That's it. So I to the power of I is a simple real number like this. Okay, but hold on, things are not done yet. We need to solve it further. For example, not only this I power I is 0.207879, so on so forth like that, there is also something like this. See, because e power I theta is equal to, we have cos theta plus I sine theta. So we plugged in e power I theta, theta as pi by 2. So then cos pi by 2 is 0. Then we got I sine pi by 2, where sine pi by 2 is 1. So therefore it is I. Not only for this, e power I 5 pi by 2 is also equal to I. And not only for this, e power I 9 pi by 2. In this case also we get I. E power, just add 4 in the numerator, 4 pi every time. So you get, just add 4 pi in the numerator. So equal to I and so on. Yeah. So therefore when we use pi by 2 in this case, then we obtained e power minus pi by 2 in I power I. So you see, in I power I, in place of I, if I use e power I pi by 2, we get e power minus pi by 2, and that is we obtain 0.207879, so on like that. Now when we plug in I is equal to e power I 5 pi by 2, so now you plug in this. So this is what you have, right? So you plug in this one. Now this one, what happens now? So e power I 5 pi by 2 again whole power I. So this is e power negative 5 pi by 2. Now what is e power negative 5 pi by 2? It's approximately equal to 0.000388, so on. All right. So similarly here, now what do you have? So in place of I put this. So e power I 9 pi by 2 raised to the power of again I. So what is I multiplied by I? I square is negative 1. So this becomes e power minus 9 pi by 2. Okay. Now this would be approximately equal to, this would be approximately equal to next to decimal point, you have approximately say I think 6 zeros, 7, 2, 4, so on. That means final conclusion is this: I power I is a real number, right? Though we have two imaginary numbers here, imaginary units, still we have real numbers. But still this I power I is not a single valued. If someone says I power I is always 0.20787957, that is incorrect. I power I is multi-valued, okay? Because along with this 0.2078 so on, also we have 0.0003, 8 and so on. And also we have this 0.60724, so on like that. So you can keep on do, okay? E power I 17 pi by 2, or e power I 21 pi by 2, e power I 25 pi by 2. For all these cases we get I, okay? And again this quantity you plug in here and you try to find out this I power I, okay? So one of the great mysterious concepts we have unfolded, okay? Bye for now. Thank you.